Greetings and welcome to the Introduction to Astronomy. One of the things that I like to do in each of my introductory astronomy classes is to begin the class with the astronomy picture of the day from the NASA website, that is apod.nasa.gov/apod. And today's picture for February the 7th of 2021, well, it is titled Blue Straggler Stars in Globular Cluster M53. So what do we see here? Well, this is an example of a globular cluster, which is a grouping of many stars, 100,000 stars or so, that are tightly bound together by their own gravity. So globular clusters will remain and last because there is enough gravity there to keep the stars from wandering away and wandering off into space. And that differentiates it from what we call an open cluster, which are generally young clusters, which are do not have enough mass to hold them together. And those stars would, over time, eventually dissipate out into the rest of the galaxy. Now, these globular clusters are some of the oldest parts of our galaxy, many of them 10 billion years old or more, dating back to the origins of our galaxy. And what we're looking at here are called blue straggler stars. Now, what is a blue straggler? Well, they are stars that are too blue to really exist anymore in a cluster of this age. So in a globular cluster, all the stars formed at once, say 10 or 11 billion years ago. And since then, they've been going through their lives. Now, if that was the case, the most massive stars that should be left in a cluster like this would be something like the Sun. So since we're seeing bluer stars than should be present, it means there must be some way of making a more massive star that should not have been around in this cluster. And what we think they may be is stars that have added matter to them. So for example, if you have stars in a binary system, two stars close together, one of those stars, when it ages, could expand enough that material could flow from one star to the other. And if a sufficient amount of mass is able to do that, we could make stars of a mass that no longer should exist in this cluster, but find a lot of them in the cluster, which we do. Now, that would happen a lot in a globular cluster where you have lots of stars packed closely together. So it would be a very amazing nighttime sky if we lived on a planet within the central portions of a globular cluster, where the night sky would be just filled with extremely bright stars. A typical star in our galaxy, in our part of the galaxy, are several light years away, and stars here would be many times closer than that. So we could see, we have a very amazing sight if you had a chance to live on a planet within a globular cluster like this one. And we use things like those blue straggler stars to help us understand a lot about the cluster and the universe itself. So that was our picture of the day for February the 7th of 2021. It was titled Blue Straggler Stars in Globular Cluster M53. We'll be back again tomorrow for the next picture, previewed to be Ripples of Star. So we'll see what that is about tomorrow. And until then, have a great day, everyone, and I will see you in class.